Second quarter in Raleigh, Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt, as you look at Chris Winkie, who had a marvelous start with a 74-yard touchdown pass on the first play from scrimmage to Peter Warrick, but has struggled since then.
But the story of the game is NC State. They really did dominate the quarter outside of those few big plays. There's a look at Mark Richt up in the booth. He's the offensive coordinator. And, of course, those interceptions didn't help. But I'll tell you this, NC State, when you think of the last three quarters last year's game and this quarter, have outscored Florida State 48-27.
And that stat coming via Les Robinson, the athletic director at NC State. First play overthrows the intended receiver. Les dropping that off. We'll expect Dave Hart to come in with a stat in a little bit.
Well, we had the privilege of doing last year's game down in Tallahassee. And Florida State went up big. And then NC State scored 35 points on those five touchdown catches by Holt. And then outscored them in that quarter. So four straight quarters, they've outscored them.
It's a defense for Bobby Bowden that the secondary men, take Cody especially, had some comments this week that they were going to take Torrey Holt out of this game and they were going to shut down Torrey Holt. And obviously that's exactly what they're trying to do. But Holt having a big day, including a punt return for a touchdown. There's the fullback, Harold Jackson, out of the backfield. Pass across midfield. The Wolfpack moving the football at will, it seems, against this Florida State defense. That's been the biggest surprise so far this game.
Had the big guys in there. They ran the wide receiver off, then they sent the fullback right down here in the flat. Brought him in right off the tackle, out into the flat. Now watch the block he gets out in front of him. Boom! That's the big tight end Smith who gave him the block and let him pick up 3 extra yards, so they moved the chains again, and NC State continues to move the ball effectively on offense.
Well, the Seminoles had, 12 days to get ready for this game. And that's the worst thing that they could have because they beat each other up in practice. That's where they got all their injuries for the most part. The freshman, Ray Robinson, scampers down to the 41-yard line. Robinson from Hilton Head High School in Hilton Head, South Carolina. Well, it is time now for our Aflac trivia question. Here's this week's question. What ACC team has the current longest winning streak? Come back in a couple of minutes, give you the answer.
Great question.
Doesn't pay to play a bowl game. That's the only hint I'll give you.
Oh, that was you.
There goes Robinson over the left side.
Gave it away.
Maybe about a yard shy of a first down. I'd like people to be successful. Be able to answer these questions.
I want to play Jeopardy with you.
Longest current winning streak. 13-28 and counting. And after the first play from scrimmage, Tim, it looked like Florida State would have about 21, 28 points just going into the second quarter. But NC State able to come up with a couple of big interceptions to stop their drive. Holt in motion this time. Threw it right in back of him. Well, he got a hand on it, but it was a little bit...
You know, actually, that ball should have been caught.
You think so?
And what a great route. They sent him in motion, and they've been sending him to the outside. Watch this. Here he comes in motion right here. Now he's going to go and then come back like that. Watch this. And just leaves the defensive back there. Now watch. See the ball? A little bit behind him, but... And it was thrown too hard, too. But Barnett's been pretty sharp today. You know that? In 19 starts, he throws for 200 or more yards 12 times. He's going to get maybe that today.
Well, if he goes on to put up the same numbers this year and next year in his senior year, he would project to be in the top three all-time in ACC numbers. Here was kick inside the five. Troy Wolfpack getting the break. 35-yard punt. And Jackson, the fullback, down there. So Irwin maybe making up for the next extra point a little bit. And the Noles trying to get some offense going now. And that is the right score. 13-7, NC State on top of Florida State. 4:56 left until halftime. So far, the story has been the NC State offense and the two interceptions thrown by Chris Winkie. 4 of 10. The two big pass plays to Peter Warrick and Lavernius Coles, but that's been it. Winky going to pitch it back. Miner looking for room. Still up and out to the 7-yard line. Well, Winkie, the starter, of course, one of the reasons, because Dan Kendra went down with a knee injury in the spring. Kendra, the man who was supposed to take over as the quarterback, look at the hit by Bradley Jennings that tore the ACL on Kendra's knee. It would end his career as a quarterback, at least. He'll come back as a fullback.
A lot of people really were concerned because they said, you know, he hit him high. They don't know how he injured his knee, but what happened is with the impact, his cleat was caught and twisted the knee and tore the ACL. Then had that offseason, or over the summer, had that problem with some explosives in his home that blew up. So he's not back. He's going to be a fullback when he comes back.
There goes Lavernius Coles on the reverse. Outside of the one tackler, trying to get to the first down. He may be there. He's out to the 13-yard line, maybe the 14. Rodney Redd ran him out.
Going back to Dan Kendra for a second, we were talking with Mark Richt, the offensive coordinator, earlier this week, and he said, you know what? He's going to make a terrific fullback in the pros. You really believe that? As soon as the pros look at him, he's the prototypical fullback for the NFL. Here's a look at Mark Richt. He's the guy who's orchestrating the offense for all the success they've had over the last several years. He says Kendra will be a great NFL fullback.
Well, Cole's just shy of the first down on that last reverse. A dangerous play to run near your goal line, but we've seen Bobby Bowden do it throughout his career. Straight ahead goes Wanky, still fighting to get there. You got the scrum going on, and we'll have to wait and see where they mark it. Looked like he had enough forward motion to get there, and he did. It's a first down for the Noles. Well, there's no question that Dan Kendra is one of the great athletes on any college campus. You just look at the guy and what he has been able to do in all the tests. And when he gets to the NFL Combine, as you said, I think his stock will go up even further after his career at Florida State. You got to feel sorry for the guy, though, coming out of high school, number one quarterback in the country, and never getting a chance to take the reins for Bobby Bowden. On first down, Wanky, under pressure, going to overthrow Warrick. Well, he has been overthrowing his receivers throughout the day. He has not been sharp. Well, kicking off ABC Premier Tuesday, the Hughleys move in right after Home Improvement. Great new hour of comedy starting September 22nd, ABC Premier Tuesday. Chris Rock, the executive producer of that show. Second down and 10. Flags on the play, complete. Ron Dugan's his first catch of the afternoon and a lot. On the far sideline, across the 40 to the 41, Dugan, who can get up about 44 inches. Leighton White made the stop, a gain of 25, but we'll check out the flag. And they're going to bring it back.
Offensively, Florida State is really struggling right now. Chris Wanky is just out of sync. The offense is not concentrated. They have a mental breakdown.
Still in the formation on the offense. A 5-yard penalty. We'll replay the bell.
This is going to drive Bobby Bowden crazy because these are just mental mistakes that Florida State normally doesn't make. And if they have aspirations of another national championship, which certainly he does, he thinks this is as talented and as fast a club as he's ever had. Well, this is the stuff that's going to kill him, so he's going to be upset.
Winky has missed his last four passes. And Florida State has talked about trying to establish the ground game with Feaster and Miner. And we'll do it a little bit with Feaster today. But not much going on elsewhere. Here goes Travis Miner trying to get that going. Still up. Long run out to the 24-yard line. Gain of 14 as you look at the power that time of Travis Miner.
He had 34 carries against Texas A&M in a career-high 146 yards. Great freshman year. Surprised at his power. Look at him, just dragging tacklers and keeping his feet. He's got that low center of gravity, but he was just dragging McCurdy, who's 265 pounds, with him.
ACC Rookie of the Year last season. And he started as a freshman. 46 yards on the afternoon, almost 6 yards per carry. Winky's going to burn a timeout as the play clock was running down. So it'll be third and one for the Seminoles with 10:24 left until halftime when we come back to Raleigh. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Ford Taurus.
Ford, built to last. Solomon Smith Barney, let's get to work. Success is earned. Burger King, if you ask us, it just tastes better. And Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you, fresh beer tastes better.
Among the trees here in Raleigh, Carter Finley Stadium, which they are actually about to improve with the basketball arena going up right next door. And right now, it's Chris Wenke trying to complete a third and one for the Seminoles and get some momentum in this first half. They have given it all the way back to NC State after they opened up strongly. Well, fullback Len going to go straight ahead and knock down at the line of scrimmage. We'll have to wait and see.
You know, I don't think he got it, Terry.
I don't either.
He was met at the line of scrimmage, depending on the mark. I don't think he had to cross or at least touch the 25-yard line, and I don't think he got it.
Well, they called the timeout, and that's what they came up with to give it to Glenn, which is you're going to give it to your fullback at 235 pounds and try to get the first down. Makes sense to me, but that Wolfpack line, which has been very thin so far this year, playing well today.
Well, LeVar Fisher tagged him pretty good. He got the first. Now, if you look at the mark on the sidelines, the mark in the chain says he had to get to the 25. The nose of that ball was just short. So Mike's saying, wait a minute, what'd that chain get shortened on it?
Now, Michael Kane was given a contract extension, even though a lot of people called for his job late last year. Then he came back against Florida State and then won three in a row to end the season. He was 6-5 and at least be bowl eligible. But he said now that he's been given an extension, he feels more pressure than he did a year ago to prove that they made the right decision. Warwick on the reverse. Cotton almost had him. Well, there goes Peter Warwick up the far sideline. Driven out of bounds about the 40-yard line. For the second time we've seen Bobby Bowden and Mark Richt go to that play. The first time that Laverne is cold.
Well, you're not losing any speed with Peter Warwick, I'll tell you that.
No.
Yeah, the big guy coming our way. He's going to try to draw all the attention now. Here comes number 9, Warwick, the Heisman Trophy candidate. Here's a guy that's averaged 18 yards every time he touches the ball for his career. He's got that speed. He can break the tackles, outrun some folks.
Candidate for the Heisman Trophy. On first down, look at what the Noles have done. And NC State up around 8 yards on first down. Minor out to the 45. Well, tomorrow at 3 Eastern here on ABC, we'll bring you the Comfort Classic in the Brickyard Crossing Golf Course in Speedway, Indiana. Senior PGA event. Hale Irwin, Lee Trevino, Gil Morgan, defending champion David Graham. By the way, Irwin and Morgan have 6 wins apiece this year on the senior tour. That's tomorrow on ABC. Ninth play of the drive for Wenke and the Noles. Plenty of time to go behind Ron Dugan. Again, Wenke with the receiver open. He was wide open, and he just threw it behind him.
They took the fullback out. They added a receiver. They spread the field. He's just not rolling well right now, and he knows he's struggling. Brian's in right now.
Well, we gave you the Aflac trivia question a few moments ago. What ACC team has the current longest winning streak? My hint?
Yeah, your hint is the hint of the century.
Doesn't pay to go to a bowl game. North Carolina State has won 4 games now with a win this year against Ohio and the 3 to close out the year.
Big third down here for NC State.
3rd and 3. Wenke with a straight drop. Picked and incomplete, almost picked off by Rodney Reddy's already intercepted one of Wenke's passes.
There again, Red, the safety playing underneath, and Wenke somehow doesn't see him. NC State with the longest win streak in the ACC. You know, they scored 35 points in the last 3 quarters against Florida State last year and have not lost since. Beat Maryland, Virginia, East Carolina, Ohio. Huge win against Virginia.
And Michael King will tell you that meant a lot confidence-wise for his Wolfpack team. Torrey Holt racing back. Going to field this one at the 2-yard line. Holt brings it back to the 7. Don't know about that decision. And let's check in the New York studios. John Saunders, see what's coming up at halftime. a milestone for Joe Pye. He said, maybe someday I'll appreciate it, but right now I just don't have time.
Great coach. He's had some of the greatest teams you'll ever see up there at Penn State. I helped make some of those All-Americans up here.
Yeah, he gives you a lot of credit, as a matter of fact. That's a 54-yard punt. Corey Holtz running back 7 yards. I'm not sure he should have fielded that one, though. And the Wolfpack ahead for a couple, trying to get some breathing room with 8:22 and counting until half.
Critical error by the All-American Holtz to field that ball. It was clearly going into the end zone for a touchback, and he picked it up on the 2-yard line inside the 2 and tried to return it. And I think in doing that, he actually injured himself. Took a shot on his thigh. But a bad mistake back upstate.
It was a playoff. Now he's back in there. 3 receivers set. Leap and Hamrick to the near side. Play action for Barnett. Pass time. Holt coming back, but broken up. That's a great play. Well covered. And Clemont Thomas broke it up with a dive.
If you hear what the fans think, Thomas was riding it and was too early on the back. Take a look and you make the call. You tell me if this is pass interference. There's a hands on. There's the left hand using it to get leverage. There's no question he's on him. He was there too early. It should have been a flag for pass interference.
Well, for once, the fans are right, I guess.
Well, he's used that left hand for leverage, and normally when that happens, they'll throw a flag. But then he also kind of rode his back.
Play clock down to 1, and Barnett gets it. He has time to run and rule, but he's going to throw it through the hands of Chris Coleman. That's a play that maybe you see some of the residual effect of the knee. He had at least 18 yards ahead of him to run.
And Mike O'Kane was saying he had that opportunity once last week against Ohio, and I'm sure he's going to tell him when he gets to the sideline, you know, you've got to tuck that away and run with it. Definitely could have picked up the first.
Well, one of the things that makes Jamie Barnett an effective quarterback and has allowed him to do what he's done in the ACC is the threat to run.
I don't think Mike wants to talk to him. They're playing too well right now. NC State played a heck of a half.
Earwood back in his own end zone. Noel's going to set up a return. And great field position. He's good. To the 31-yard line. So Florida State with the best field position of the day.
See, and this goes back to that decision that Holt made to field that punt on the 2. See, it gives them good field position now.
Your exclusive home for primetime NFL action Sunday night, live at 8:15 on ESPN. Drew Bledsoe taking on Peyton Manning as New England tackles Indianapolis this week. And then Monday night on ABC Sports, Monday Night Football, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Steve Young, Jerry Rice. And the 49ers take on the Washington Redskins with a new quarterback this week on Monday Night Football.
Redskins had a great first half against the Giants last week. And then Gus Bratt threw those 2 interceptions to start the second half, put the Redskins in a hole they eventually lost. And North Turner didn't waste any time changing quarterbacks, going to young Trent Green out of Indiana.
Flag on the play. We'll find out what it's about from Ronald Cherry.
On the defense. That's a 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. We played it there.
That's actually a break for NC State.
Sure is. The Noles had the ball to 32 after Beaster caught it at the 40 and brought it back 8 yards. So they'll punt away again. And look at the big plays that the Wolfpack has enjoyed today. 68 yards on the return by Holt. The interception right at the goal line. And then Rodney Redd coming up with one. This is made. A beauty back to the 38. Beaster finds a hole though. Beaster cutting it back with a big return. Still on his feet and now tackled at the 23-yard line.
So they made 9 yards.
So it turns out to be a break for Florida State, in fact. 55 yards on the punt, but Beaster brought it back 29.
You know, as soon as you said there's a long punt, the difference, a lot of times that long punt can set up a great turn because the cover team, they overrun their coverage, gives a little seam back there too. Ball hangs for a while. Now see, these guys have all overrun. They're over on the right side. All he needs is an alley, gets 2 blocks, and it takes it all the way back to the 23.
I'll kick your coverage.
So the penalty then, they pick up 9 yards, and now they start this series inside the 25.
Out of the shotgun, Winky. They throw it up in the air, an awful pass, and Miner almost came back to get it. That's a ball that had to slip out of the hand of Chris Winky.
Winky's got to be wondering what the heck is going on. Look, he's even shaking his head. I mean, the ball was not thrown with its normal velocity, I think, because he was waiting for him to clear a route. So you'll see him hesitate, and the ball just kind of comes out of his hand, but it's a dead duck.
Confident sign for Winky, trying to get it back. 4 of 14 on the day. Stepping down. Fires one into Ron Dugan's complete to the 13-yard line. And close to a first down. Dugan's with his second catch of the afternoon, the junior from Tallahassee.
One thing about Florida State and Winky, these guys are in complete control at all times, even when things aren't going well. You look at the time, and you say, well, you got 7:07 remaining in the half. There's no panic in Florida State. I don't think Alton is even thinking that he's going to get a shot today unless the score gets big, because Wanky's the guy. And Wanky, even though he's struggling, he threw that last one with velocity. They're still in control of this ballgame, even though they trail.
He's got the helmet on. He's ready, just in case. First down for the Noah. Initially, but the second effort down to the 7-yard line. What a spin move by Travis Miner. Rashad Street, number 98, eventually made sure he was on the ground.
Watch this. Here comes Miner. He gets hit and then takes that momentum just to use it to turn him. And so he's spinning like a whirling dervish in the line, picks up a couple of extra yards.
Second down, there goes Travis again, this time to the outside. Can he get to the end zone? The dodge, yes. Touchdown Florida State, but there is a flag back at the 8-yard line.
Going to be holding on Nick Franklin, the wideout. And they didn't even need it.
Yeah, Franklin, the tight end on the right side of the line, didn't need it with minor speed.
Holding offense. That's a 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay the down.
Franklin was way wide outside. Here he is at the top of your screen, 81. All right, now there goes Miner around him. And Franklin tackles the outside contain man. He's flood control, but Miner was already around the corner.
Mistake coming back to hurt the Noles. 4 penalties, 35 yards. One of which was on the defensive end. And there's a key one inside NC State territory. NC State to keep that 99-yard drive alive. Pump fake. Winky has time. Plenty of time. And underthrows the receiver at the 20-yard line. The tight end, Myron Jackson, was open.
Bobby Cotton, he had a beat on Winky, too. He came, he's the one that finally hit him. But when he saw him cut back, he was thinking, oh, I'm going to get an all-time lick here.
Well, Winky had time, but it was time on the move. He was having to hop around back in the pocket.
Winky's awfully mobile for his size. He's 6'5", 230. But I think that time he panicked. He turned around. He saw Cotton coming. Just tried to throw the backside. This is a huge third down for NC State and Florida State.
For an NC State defense that read all week in the papers how bad they were. For giving up 361 yards on the ground to Ohio. This is a different offense, though, from Florida State.
Winky had to take a timeout, or he was going to get another flag for delay of game.
Third and almost 16 for Winky and the Noles when we come back.
So, what will it take for you to buy this car today?
You're buying this SUV?
Wolfpack leading 13-7 in a key third down coming up for Florida State right now. Third and 15, and this is what Winky has done, one of the last nine. Not what he hoped for. Came in expecting to open it up. Now, this is a Florida State team that has been there before, and Winky in the kickoff classic against Texas A&M, with all the adversity, kept his poise, kept his cool, came back to run the offense in the second half very well. Plenty of time over the middle. Intercepted. Intercepted in the end zone by number 9, Jason Perry. The second interception of the day for the Wolfpack defense down at the goal line and the third overall.
Well, the second for the safety. And Red almost had a third. But they came up. He was trying to locate the safeties. They were playing soft, he thought. Then he went for the post pattern. And all of a sudden, here comes Perry. Perry and Red have been playing underneath all day. Now watch this. It's the corner coverage, but he released them to the safety, number 9, Perry. And then the ball's out in front of him a little bit. Perry makes the pick. That's two interceptions for the safety, one for Harrison, and Red almost had another one.
Winky has locked on to Peter Warrick time and time again, and his NC State defense has had at least one defender right there with him. Rashawn Strike tripped up at the line of scrimmage, but he falls ahead for a gain of about 4.
Mike O'Kane would like nothing more than to see NC State knock off 4, 5 yards, 6 yards, 4 yards, 5 yards, and eat up the last 5.5 minutes of this first half to get some points at the end of it. Don't let that Florida State offense back on the field.
Torrey Holt split wide right with Hamrick inside in the slot. There goes Holt in motion. They move him around a lot in that backfield. And on the line, quick out to the fullback, Jeff Butler, across the 25 to the 26-yard line.
That's a nicely designed play. They send Holt in motion, send him deep, bring the fullback underneath of him. So in other words, the wide receivers, including the All-American, are taking everybody deep, then they just bring him underneath into the open area.
Now, we saw State use Holt as a decoy earlier on the touchdown to Leak in the end zone. Two defenders went right with Torrey Holt, and Eric Leak wide open in the flat. There goes Holt in motion again across to the opposite side of the field. Comes back wide open underneath. Holt with a big gain again. And Barnett finding Torrey Holt almost on every play now for the pack. Out to the 37-yard line. He gives him at least one look, even if he goes to a different receiver. That's Corey Simon in stereo. Down on the field.
Watch what they do with Holt. They take him in motion to the left. Then as soon as he breaks up field, he'll cut back to the right under the linebackers. Look at this. And then Barnett knows where he's going and just gets it out in front of him. First down. He knows when you get man coverage, he can outrun him by going in motion and then coming back across the opposite way the man's covering him.
Now, Florida State may have to make an adjustment on that because they've been able to run that throughout the first half. Well, next Saturday, live at 3:30 Eastern time here on ABC Sport. Most of you in this region will see the Clemson Tigers take on Virginia. Had the big win against Auburn today against Maryland. Some of you, including those in Florida, Missouri and Ohio State. Other games on tap, BYU and Washington, Texas and Kansas State. So check with your cable operator or your satellite system to get those games on pay-per-view. College football in full swing here on ABC. Jamie Barnett, I like the way things have gone so far. There was some concern that he wasn't in game condition after that knee injury and coming in, and really couldn't tell a whole lot in the performance against Ohio because it was a game in which you had to run the ball almost exclusively.
But Barnett's had a tremendous first half here as well. As a matter of fact, he's 9 for 17, 152 yards. But the big stat is zero interceptions, no turnovers, but he does have the one touchdown.
And he's been knocked down in sacks, but it really hasn't been the pressure you'd expect from Florida State. An offensive line doing a great job for the Wolfpack. Good to see Corey Simon walking off after the injury.
We were just talking about with Barnett, and of course, to me, out of all those numbers, the biggest stat is zero turnovers.
And one sack on the afternoon for the Seminoles. Big numbers for Holt, plus the punt return. First and 10 at the 37. Again, plenty of time for Barnett. Holt got a contact. Will there be a flag yet? They were all over Torrey Holt at the 20-yard line. Dexter Jackson got his hat taken off. And he is down and injured.
This was just a fly pattern, and they had the corner and the safety coming over. Now watch. He's just going to try to outrun him. The ball's already in the air. Now watch. They're looking back for the ball, and he just runs right up the back of Torrey Holt. So the interference is on Mario Edwards, who is the nickelback. They had him doubled, and by looking back for the ball, and with Holt flowing up for the catch, he just ran right up his back past interference.
Edwards coming back off that year of suspension, along with Sean Key, and the backup for Troy Saunders. Injury being at least two on the field. While we have a moment, we step away to see what's coming up on ABC program right now. By the way, Tim Grant rides around a minivan, right?
Absolutely.
You got the whole family in that thing.
Sure do.
Cool for you. Good to see Dexter Jackson up and walking off the field. There's Mario Edwards. Troy Saunders having the problems at cornerback, beaten a couple of times, and the interference calls against Texas A&M. Edwards getting the playing time today. Saunders started, but right now Edwards not faring so well.
Well, you mentioned Saunders struggled against A&M. He had a holding penalty, a pass interference, and was spun around a couple of times. But he kept him in there because Saunders, who came back, as you said, from that suspension, really doesn't have a grasp of everything they're trying to do defensively. I think that time he was in the right coverage. He was just moving back and ran up his back.
Didn't play the ball.
Right.
So the penalty, automatic first down for the Wolfpack. Ray Robinson, number five, along with Harold Jackson out of the eye. There goes Robinson, wrapped up at the line of scrimmage.
Robinson carries for short yardage.
Tony Bryant. Number 40, the defensive end, a senior out of Marathon, Florida. In on the stop, we were told actually moments ago that he was going to be out with a shoulder injury. He injured it earlier this week, but he is back in there, and he made the stop. 3:37 and counting in the first half. Here comes Holt in motion. In at all times, but it's going to the tight end now. Devon Smith for a big game to the 15-yard line, knocked out by Sean McCulker. They went with Holt, and they threw back to the vacated area.
He is a big guy, too. Smith is 6'4", 250. Picked up 32 yards, but watch this. You're right. Holt again. Everybody's watching him. A little play action. They send Holt out of the area, and underneath, here comes your tight end, Devon Smith. And look at the big guy, he gets rolling. And watch this. Yes, sir. He's got the crowd going. He is a hawk. Watch him at practice. He really has so much fun just playing the game.
Florida State going to take a timeout. Look at the Wolfpack players trying to get the crowd out of their seats.
Gary, again, Mike O'Kane's got to be thinking, and this is not a normal situation when you play Florida State, but he's got to be thinking, I don't want to score too quickly here. There's still 3:18 to play in the first half. You don't want to give the ball back to the Seminoles.
At the same time, you've got a field goal kicker. If you take your chance running the ball a couple times and get stopped, but he's already missed an extra point, already missed a field goal. He can't be all that confident. He'd love to get a touchdown on the board before the half. Now the five touchdown catches, Torrey Holt, we've all talked about it. We asked Torrey to describe them to us. Here's what he said.
First one was a real route, Jamie found me, touchdown. Second one was a nice flag route, Jamie found me again, touchdown. The third one was just a quick streak, speed, touchdown. The fourth touchdown was a real route, Jamie found me in end zone, touchdown. The fifth one was a short flag route. I was all alone in the end zone. Charles did a good job of finding me, touchdown. I was tired, too. I was moving around all day with linebackers and safeties. It worked out pretty good for me.
It worked out pretty good for me. He said.
There's another guy. He had more fun sitting in a room and watching those touchdowns. Today he's got four catches, 62 yards. Also has that 88-yard return on the punt. But still, I say, the most important thing today for NC State, no penalties, no turnovers. And here again, threatening with 3:18 to play in the first half.
And they've moved him around, too. He's been in motion much of the day. Now, split wide to the right. He's going to come back. Down goes Barnett, though. He wanted to throw to Holt. Tony Bryant got there before he could release the football.
Holt was open, too. They were going to run that flanker screen that was successful earlier. Look at Holt laughing. He knows he was open. The one thing they told Barnett, throw in rhythm, don't wait. Otherwise, they'll catch you. For some reason, he held the ball. Right now, Holt's open. But instead, he's seeing something and wants him to release and give him that pump fake, and that caused the sack.
He may have been pump faking downfield to create some reaction downfield, but he had Holt wide open
underneath. Sure.
He can't wait. Second and 18 now, and Holt back in motion. Over the middle of the field, Barnett, no time again. And here comes an old defense. This is what everyone expected. Jerry Johnson and Corey Simon applying the pressure up the middle. The third sack of the afternoon. They got to,
this is a jailbreak.
Got to Barnett again.
Watch this. I mean, they're shooting the gap right away, and the linebacker comes on a blitz. That's Green, 45. Straight up the middle, he gets cut off at the end, but Johnson gets there to tie him, and all of a sudden, Florida State was all over him.
NC State takes the timeout. That's their last of the first half. Florida State, no timeout left.
Bad news is that they've lost about 16 yards. The good news is the clock melted down to 2:17.
Now, when you do games with Florida State involved, almost every time when you talk to the opposing coaches, they make one point. We got to keep the ball. The Florida State can't score when we have it. And that's what NC State is doing right now, although that's not necessarily true. You see them, Mickey Andrews, club plus, plenty of turnover and bring it back.
Right now, they're not even in Earwood's range. I mean, 41 yards, you're not comfortable with him there.
Missed a 44-yarder earlier in the game. Three sacks allowed last year, and three so far today.
Now, do you get greedy and go into the end zone with a shot to Holt, or do you try to hit him where he can get into field goal range and maybe break a few tackles to score? I say you go and try to hit him somewhere on the field, set up the field goal. If he breaks a couple, you get a shot.
State, an average of almost 11 yards to go on third down. Florida State less than a yard. Well, Florida State defense coming out with the two sacks on this drive, trying to get their crowd involved in it too. Robinson caught behind the line of scrimmage. They're going to blow it dead though. There were flags all over the place.
That play didn't fool anybody. They sent
no
Leak and Holt down the right side, tried to throw back on. Let's see who it's against.
The dead ball. Encroachment on the offense.
Now they whistled that dead before the play even got underway. First penalty for NC State on the afternoon.
So not only was it an ugly play and poor execution, they got the penalty. You hate when that happens.
Right, Texas. However, with 2:10 left in the first half, and he told Mike O'Kane that that's when he'd get his first penalty, he'd be awfully pleased with that. Mistakes have hurt Florida State this afternoon.
This has been a terrific first half.
Oh. What a gorgeous day, too, in Raleigh. In fact, if you go back four or five quarters between these two teams, the matchup, even like NC State about Florida, this one underthrown, going to be picked off. Edwards bringing it back. Out across the 40, still on his feet, and now Mario Edwards brings it back all the way to the 32-yard line, and that was exactly what you were talking about. Now Florida State, with just under 2 minutes, to try to put some points back on the board after the interception and the 50-yard return by Mario Edwards.
You're playing Florida State, and you try to do too much. Barnett was wrapped up and tried to make something happen. If you watch this now, they want him to throw when he's ready and then not hold it at all. But look, all right, now he's wrapped up right there by Johnson and still tries to throw deep. Doesn't have any power on it. Ball's underthrown, and then it's a 50-yard return.
They're going to say Mario Edwards was out just outside the yard line. So a minute 55, first and 10, and Winkie out of the gun. Quick out, Feaster, he overthrew Feaster. Ball may have been catchable, but it certainly wasn't well thrown.
NC State got some pretty good pressure on Wanky. That's been forcing him to throw badly all day. He just hadn't been in sync either. Keep in mind, Florida State trailed at halftime against Texas A&M, too, because of mistakes. Not because of physical talent.
Three receivers set to split the backs out of the shotgun. Wanky forced out of the pocket. He's going to go down back at the 42. The defensive front of NC State shocking the nose. This was supposed to be the thin part of the defense, but a loss of 17. Bobby Cotton and Greg Derrick drove Wanky back.
Yeah, but they got the push from the inside first, and then all of a sudden the outside defensive end, 36-3. That's your defensive ends right there, and all of a sudden, boom, Derrick and Cotton get a pretty good lick on Wanky. They wanted the fumble as well and didn't, but it's a loss of 17.
Defense is dominating in the last 8-9 minutes or so.
Bobby Cotton had 5 sacks last year. He had 2 hurries last week. He's the defensive captain. And Greg Derrick, pro scouts like him a lot. He's big, he's quick, he's a little bit inexperienced, but he can make things really happen.
Officials blowing it dead.
Delay a game against Florida State.
Too much time, the play clock had run out. And Bobby Bowden's club, a number of mistakes, including the 3 interceptions and 6 penalties so far for the Seminoles.
Bobby's not feeling well today. He's got a cold.
Mm-hmm.
But I guarantee you,
feeling worse right now.
He's going to light him up in the locker room.
The cold is not the worst of his problems. With 46 seconds left,
my point being, he's not in a good mood anywhere. It's going to make it worse.
Well, he wasn't in a good mood going into halftime against Texas A&M either, and they came out and dominated the second half. And it set up the screen to Miner. Across midfield. That was brought down at the 44-yard line. 24 seconds as it ticks down. They'll stop the clock.
All right, here's what's interesting, though. You've got Sebastian Janikowski, your field goal kicker, who's hit a 56-yarder. He had a couple more 60 in high school. He could get a 70-yarder, they say. They feel comfortable that he could get a 70-yarder in the right situation.
Jimmy, that was my point. They'll stop the clock if they get a first down, but they can't stop it right now to get him on the field. The Noles got a timeout. And the clock is going to run out. It is not the end of the first half that Bobby Bowden hoped for. Now well executed. Mike Kane with the lead, 13-7. We go to New York, John Saunders, Todd Blackledge.
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 98, Matt, a finance major with a 3.96 GPA, enjoys spending time with children when away from the practice field and stresses the importance of balancing academics and football.
You focus a little bit more of your attention on the athletics at some points, but